Hi, I'm J.B. Friday, Extension Forester with the University of Hawaii. We're here on another forestry field day. Today it's to a nursery, and we're going to be discussing proper forestry containers for forestry and conservation nurseries. We're here with Eileen Ye at Pouaiu Nursery here in Hilo, Hawaii. So Eileen, what types of containers are you using, and why are you using them?
I use a lot of different kinds of containers, and it really depends on how long the seedling mm-hmm. will take to grow out, how big the seed is, and what kind of taproot it has. If it has a long taproot, I usually go for a deeper tube, such as this.
Okay, so what is this?
This is a milo.
It's a milo. And how old is the seedling?
This seedling was sown April 19th.
Oh, so it's just 1 month old now. So it's a pretty fast-growing seedling. And you have it in this is the SC10 size, right?
Yes.
So the separate dibble tube.
Mm-hmm.
And same size container. You've got some koa trees growing in here.
Yes.
How old are these?
These are about 4 months old. And this one, I did it in a long tube because it's going to an area that's fairly dry. And so I wanted something that would have a deep taproot.
Okay.
And it was part of their specifications as to what size tube to use.
Can I pull it out?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so you've got pretty nice root development here. And it's you can see the roots are going straight down without spiraling in this. Is this ready to go? Ready to be planted out?
Yes, it is.
How much longer would you keep this in the nursery before planting it?
I would say no more than a month.
Not more than a month,
not
then it'll get popped
out after
that. So these trees in the larger plant bands, what are these?
These are manono, which used to be hideotis and now it's kadua. And these are a native plant that's found in more of the wetter areas, so the wetter forests. And the reason I chose this pot was I like the size. It's easy to pack. It makes a nice root ball. But this one would not be able to stay in this pot that long. And it's
when did you plant this?
This was sown December 19, 2012.
So they're just 5 months old. And I see you've marked on the tag when they are, so you know how old they are.
Yes.
Can I slide this one out?
Sure.
Can I see the roots on this? So it's holding together. The potting mix is... And what's your potting mix here?
This is a mixture of sunshine mix number 4
mm-hmm.
with some perlite added. And then I throw in a little bit of osmocote.
And I can see, again, the roots are not spiraling.
Mm-hmm.
And then these pots are also open on the bottom.
Yeah.
So the roots air prune on the bottom of those.
Yeah.
Now, how about this one here? What's this?
Okay, this is also manono or kadua, and it's the same age, but when I was doing the transplanting, if the seedlings are bigger,
mm-hmm.
I kind of tend to put them in bigger pots because I don't want them to be crowded.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I usually start them in community flats, so they have a whole bunch of seedlings come up.
So how much longer in the nursery? Are these ready to go out now to be planted? They look like they're good.
This one is ready.
And how much longer in the nursery could you hold this if you needed to?
Maybe two months, 3 months.
2 months more.
Yeah.
So the bigger container gives you a little more leeway in times of outplanting. That's good. Here we have a koa seedling, 4-month-old koa seedling, grown in one of the SC10 tubes. And we're going to remove the tube so we can look at the root structure. So we see the roots here go straight down the sides of the container because the container has ribs on the inside and don't spiral around. When they hit the end of the container, they're air pruned. They hit the air and they stop growing. We can also see on this koa seedling there's good nodulation, a lot of nitrogen fixing nodules on the roots. This is showing the root plug of a older koa seedling. It's about a 6-month-old seedling, and it's grown in a smaller cell, SC7 cell. You can see here that the roots have become compacted in, and the seedlings have become root-bound. It's been too long in the cell here, and you have just a solid mass of roots here. This tree will not grow well when it's outplanted. Hi, I'm here with Nick Koch with Forest Solutions. Nick's growing koa trees in a container that he particularly likes. And so, Nick, what kind of container is this, and what do you like about it?
This is a BCC container. BCC is a company that makes pots. And it's 65 cc's in size. I particularly like the square shape and the side slits and bottom holes that allow for air pruning, which keeps the roots from strangling the tree once it's outplanted in the field.
How old are the seedlings?
These seedlings are 10 weeks old.
Are they ready to go on the ground now?
As you can see, they're quite vigorous. They're ready to go on the ground. And the way we find out in the nursery is we pull them from its pot and find out if it's got a well-formed and solid root ball. Of course, the shoot ratio is also important, but mainly we're looking at the root development in the nursery.
So do you inoculate the seedlings in the nursery?
Yes, we inoculate the seedlings in the nursery. First, we collect nodules, such as these, from the field, from larger trees that have many of them. Then we grind these nodules in a solution with water, filter that water, and apply it to the pot. And the seedlings are about this tall for about 2 weeks or 3 weeks into their growth cycle. These seedlings do not grow this way. We pack them just prior to shipping. These are on their way to the field. When they're grown, we grow them with some space between each pot to allow for lateral branch and actually lateral leaf development at this stage, so that we don't get tall, skinny seedlings in the field. We call those seed type of seedlings lollipop trees. We try not to get that. When we're getting close to putting them in the field, we pack them together and put them in a tray like so. One of the things I really like about these tree pots is the free airflow we have on the in the underneath. This allows for good root pruning, air pruning, and also controls the diseases such as fungi, which are a real problem in our nurseries.
We're here in Kona with the Future Forest Nursery, and with me is Jill Wagner, who is the owner and manager of Future Forest Nursery. She does propagation both of native Hawaiian species and of commercial forestry species for reforestation projects. So Jill, what kind of containers are you using for your trees here?
I like three kinds of containers. This is a dibble tube.
Mm-hmm. Here.
This is a band pot, and this is a tree pot.
Oh, okay.
And I like square containers. They train the roots to go down instead of swirling. Round pots tend to cause swirling. And this dibble tube, if it's kept, produces a nice straight root.
Okay, you can see how the roots go straight down on the edges of that.
Yes.
Now, how about the root pruning too, the air pruning? I can see that all containers are open at the bottom.
That's right.
The dibble tube is, the tree pot is, and the band pot is.
Yes.
So the roots stop growing.
That's
so you don't get that growing along the bench phenomenon or
right.
swirling.
Yes.
So what kind of container is this one?
This is a band pot, and this is a little larger volume than a dibble tube, and it produces a straight root.
Oh, there you go. That looks good.
And you can see that it's open at the bottom, which causes root pruning. And the roots will grow down, and they will not spiral at the bottom. They'll just stop growing there.
And then branch out and form another root. So you
right.
can see even the small plant is able to hold the root plug for this whole amount of soil.
Yes, and I like these for native plants a lot. A little bigger volume produces a better plant for native plants. And some native plants have tap roots, and they need a little more space.
What size is this, and what do you like these for?
This is a tree pot, and again, it's a square pot, which makes a nice straight root pruning. But if we have a plant that needs more space and more developed root system, we might use a larger pot. In Hawaii, we like these band pots for native mm-hmm. plants, but this, if we have, we're dealing with a lot of lava, so we can't dig big holes.
For the big tree pots, it's
yes,
hard. Yeah,
it's hard. But if we have an opportunity for a bigger hole, then we'd like a larger plant, then we would use a tree pot.
Isn't it a lot more expensive to grow per plant in tree pots than in plant bands?
Yes, because you're using a lot more media. So, and you've got to water more, too. So.
But you can grow a plant for longer in one of these, and if you want an older or larger plant, right?
Right.
But that's more expensive again.
Right.
And then the cheapest of them all would be the dibble tube.
Dibble tube, and those are more for doing forestry, you know, hardwoods, or plants with a faster rotation in terms of its seed to field ready
oh, okay.
for nursery. With native plants, you've got to have a little more well-developed plant.
So for the jalapepe, what's your seed to field ready time on these?
Oh, probably about 9 months to a year.
And then for the lulu palm?
Oh, a couple of years.
A couple of years. How
yeah.
old is this plant?
Oh, 2 years old.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Ready to outplant now?
Yes.
Excellent.
Field ready now.
An advantage of growing trees, seedlings, and dibble tubes is that you can space the dibble tubes out on the rack. Here we see Honduran mahogany growing. Because it's a broadleaf tree, the seedlings need to be spaced out to give them enough room on the racks, and the racks allow you to do that with the dibble tubes. Here we see a native Hawaiian bidens grown in the plant bands, and these seedlings are spaced out just by putting empty pots between the full ones in order to space out the seedlings to give them enough room to grow. Hi, I'm J.B. Friday with the University of Hawaii, and we're here with another forestry field day. With me is Baron Horiuchi, who is the horticulturist at Hakalau National Wildlife Refuge, and Baron is showing us some of the seedlings and some of the containers he's growing here. So what kind of container is this you got here?
This is a root maker plant container, and we put the plants in there and the roots come out like this. There's little pockets, little openings on the sides where the roots come out and get air pruned.
Mm-hmm. So do you seed directly into this, or do you transplant seedlings into this?
I transplant tiny seedlings into this.
So the steps on this stop the roots from spiraling?
Yes.
And this one thing is about a gallon size, but it takes four seedlings
yes.
in it. What kind of seedling is this?
This is a Nile.
And what do you have here?
This is an Ohia.
So the roots on this look really good, and you can see they're not spiraling at all, and the square shape also keeps it nice and square on this. How old is the Nile in this one?
This Nile seedling is about 6 months old right now.
Here we have a koa tree seedling that's been grown too long for such a small container. This is about a 7 cubic inch container, not the 10 cubic inch containers. And the tree has been grown for 6 months. So it is way tall for the amount of roots, so it has a poor shoot to root ratio, too much shoot to the root. And when we remove the container, we can see that the roots are very compacted in here. The plant has become pot bound. It's really just a hard mass of roots. This seedling won't do well when it's planted out and should have been planted out a couple months ago.